Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing functions of several variables. Let's start with a simple example. So consider the function f of xy equal to x squared plus y squared. Find f of 2 comma 3. So f of xy is an example of a function of several variables. It has an input, x comma y, and the output is x squared plus y squared. Let's go ahead and work this out. Solution. We have f of 2, 3. So in this case, x is 2 and y is 3. So all we do is we substitute those numbers into the formula for f. So instead of x squared, we'll have 2 squared, and we have a plus sign. And instead of y squared, we have 3 squared. So 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9. We get 4 plus 9, and that's 13. In this particular example, the ordered pair 2, 3, this belongs to the domain of the function. It's an input. And the number 13, this belongs to the range of the function. It's an output. Let's do some examples of actually finding domain and range. Find the domain and range. Part A, f of xy equals y times the square root of x. Let's go ahead and carefully work through this solution. Start by finding the domain. So the domain is basically the set of inputs. It's everything you can plug in for x and y that makes sense. So y is here by itself, and there's no issues. We can plug anything in for y. But here we have the square root of x. And recall that whenever you have the square root of x, that means x can't be negative. In other words, it has to be greater than or equal to 0. So that's going to be a condition that we need to use in our domain when we write down the answer. I'm going to use the letter D for domain. And the domain is a set of ordered pairs because the ordered pairs here are inputs. Really important to put the bracket notation like this. It's the set of all ordered pairs, x, y, such that, and then we just have to specify x. X has to be greater than or equal to 0. You could say something about y, but it's not really necessary. Most books don't. You could say it though, so I will. I'll put a little comma and I'll say y is real. In other words, it's a real number and it could be any number. This would be the answer for the domain. The set of all ordered pairs, x, y, such that x is greater than or equal to 0 and y is real. As far as the range, that's basically all of the outputs. So the square root of x, that can't have every output, but y can, right? Y can be any number. So therefore, this whole expression, y square root of x, can be any number. So the range in this case is equal to all real numbers. So negative infinity to infinity. Part B, we have f of x, y equals the natural log of 3 minus x minus y. Let's go ahead and find the domain and range solution. Just to be different, let's find the range first this time. So to do that, we really want to think about what the graph of the natural log looks like. So this is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. And the natural log of x has a vertical asymptote along the y-axis. And the actual graph itself looks something like this. This is just a rough sketch. This would be the graph of y equals ln x. And this goes up forever and it goes down forever. So the range of ln x is negative infinity to infinity. So in this case, it's going to be the same, negative infinity to infinity, because we do just have a natural log here. So this is going to be a real number and it can be any real number. So the range is all real numbers. As far as the domain, we can also use this graph to help us figure it out. Notice that if it was just ln x, that x has to be positive. In our particular example, it's not x. Instead, it's all of this stuff, 3 minus x minus y. So for this to make sense, in other words, for the natural log to be defined, we need to have 3 minus x minus y to be greater than 0. So for any ordered pair we plug in, this must be true. So this is the condition we need for an ordered pair to be in our domain. To solve for this, couple ways to do it. Maybe we could just add y to both sides. That might be the easiest way. So we have 3 minus x is greater than y. And if you write that backwards, That's y less than 3 minus x. Now we can write down our domain. I use the letter D again for domain. It's the set of all ordered pairs. So you have to have that little funky bracket, x comma y, such that, and then we have that y is less than 3 minus x. There's no real condition on x. You could say something like x is real, but I won't do it. I'll just leave it like this. And that would be the domain of this function. One word of warning, the most common mistake in these problems is that people forget to put the little brackets and the little x and the y in the parentheses. So try to get into a habit of writing your answers exactly like this. It will definitely help you. Let's finish up with an interesting example. Describe the level curves of f of x, y equals e to the 1 minus x squared minus y squared. Let's carefully work through this problem. This one's pretty fun. So recall that the level curves are the curves that satisfy the equation f of x, y equal to a constant. So you can use any letter you like. I'm just going to use c. In these problems where you have to find the level curves or describe them, always start with this equation. Basically, we're just taking our function and setting it equal to c. So we have e to the 1 minus x squared minus y squared, and that's equal to c. And basically, we just have to manipulate this equation until we get something familiar. Because we have an e, and it would be better if it wasn't there, what we'll do is we'll take the natural log of both sides. We have ln of e to the 1 minus x squared minus y squared, and that's equal to ln of c. Recall now from algebra a super powerful formula that says the natural log of e to the x is equal to x. So in this particular example, this whole piece here, 1 minus x squared minus y squared, that's basically our x. So the ln and the e go away, and we get 1 minus x squared minus y squared equals ln c. It's starting to look familiar, but it would be better if the x squared and the y squared were both positive. So I'm going to do some algebra here. Basically, I'm going to subtract the ln c from both sides. So we get 1 minus ln c, and then add the x squared and add the y squared to the other side. Let's write this in a more normal fashion. So we have x squared plus y squared equals 1 minus ln c. So this is the equation that describes the level curves. And this is the equation of a circle. So the level curves are actually circles. What you can actually do is you can find one of the circles if you wanted to. For example, you can plug in a value of c to get a circle. Let's plug in c equals, and this is totally contrived so that it will work out correctly. Let's do e to the 1/2. If we do that, if we plug in c equals e to the 1/2, we're going to get 1 minus ln e to the 1/2. So this is 1 minus, this goes away, so you get 1/2. So you end up with 1/2. So our equation ends up being x squared plus y squared equals 1/2. That is one of our circles. Pretty cool. This circle has a center at the origin, and it has a radius equal to the square root of 1/2. And there's infinitely many choices of C, so you can pick infinitely many numbers and you get infinitely many curves. The most important thing in this problem is that you know how to start it. Whenever you have a question where you have to find the level curves, just always take whatever your function is and set it equal to C. I hope this video has been helpful to you. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Good luck.